if they like bullied a lot, they get like very delicate.
I troubled my sister.
There's this one kid in my class, he pissed me off so much.
He's our age and he like bullies people. He says, if you don't get me the water, I'm gonna hit you.
I've been bullied once.
Yeah, I insulted him a lot.
And he's like much bigger and stronger.
These group of seniors, they caught me and like they slapped me around and stuff.
It's not only that elder people bully you, even people your age can bully you.
Some people bully because they're basically in a majority and love hurting other people.
Once you get bullied, you'll probably feel really bad for someone getting bullied and never bully them again. Or if your personality is such, you'll probably pick up the anger and go bully someone else.
I don't know what I would do actually.
But I would never go and hit someone to bully them.
I made fun of him in front of his friends, which was something that really kicked me in my conscience.
People get bullied because they feel that they're very weak.
Or were you bullying?
I grew up in Uday Park with about 15 other males and some assorted females, and I was the youngest of the lot, so I never did any bullying, A. And B, I never really got bullied. I had to stand last in line for the cricket team and go and fetch cold drinks for the boys, but no overt bullying as such. I got beaten up a few times.
What do you think bullying is?
For me, I think bullying deals more with exclusion. It's not, I mean, everybody sees it as, if you think of bullying, you think of a whole lot of boys picking on one little weak boy or something. For me, it's not about like strong picking on weak. It's basically about perceiving people as different and not accepting them for that and trying to exclude them for that reason. Yeah. See, there's two things in it. I think it's a systemic problem. Let's break it up into A, who does a growing child look up to? And this is something that can start as a child.
Yeah.
They look up to you. Today's day and age, again, we're segmenting our society. We're segmenting the way we deal with people who come and say clean in the house or, you know, drive a cab. Our kids are watching. What example are we setting our children? Secondly, it's in schools, especially in boarding schools and stuff, I would say there should be a very clearly identified policy on what constitutes bullying. It should be communicated to everybody.
Suppose a child is bullied, there's always that fear that if I tell on a kid and it's going to go back to the kid, then my life's, you know, done in for.
That fear is coming from a system that's not being able to address that problem. I think build a robust system that will address, you know, that will be able to identify what was it. Was it verbal bullying? Was it beating, whatever? And then take appropriate action and have a system in place so that whether you're a parent or a loved one or somebody a child respects or a school environment, a child can feel comfortable about coming and saying, look.
Talking about it. You're a fairly recent dad. If there's a word like recent dad. You're a new dad, so to say, right? What's going to happen tomorrow when your little one gets bullied?
That's a hard one. I'm a practicing Buddhist. I belong to this lay organization called the Bharat Soka Gakkai, and the basic objective of that is peace. And how we're encouraged to do that is like make that change in yourself. You know, I mean, we all, as Indians, we all love quoting Gandhiji, be the change you want to see in the world. But so if you can model that, if you can slowly, slowly in your community bring up a bunch of kids.
What when your child, you know, they all go through that stage, so did we, when they turn around and talk back. I'm at that stage where sometimes they do talk back, they're rude. And how would you want to be like a friend to your child, or would you be, you know, disciplinarian at the end of the day?